Boys and girls, we're on to part two, 10.2 Westward Bound. Now that we've bought the Louisiana Purchase and our economy is booming, our people, our sons and daughters, are moving out west on that newfound territory. Here's the story. During the 1800s, settlers poured into the frontier west of the Appalachian Mountains. Poverty, loneliness, and primitive lifestyles were all part of the frontier people's daily life. The main idea for today is that huge amounts of acquired land through the Louisiana Purchase and conquering our Native Americans, like in the Treaty of Greenville giving us Ohio, gave the country a large store of natural resources, provided much land for settlers to move on to and take advantage of. Moving west, how would we get there? What was the population? All that and more. In 1790, our first census revealed, or the official count of the people revealed, 4 million Americans were living in the United States. Most of these people lived east of the Appalachian Mountains. Why, might you ask? For transportation of goods. Remember, most people were still farmers in 1790. They had to get their goods to market quickly. They had to do it by living close to the Atlantic, where those ports were. In 1820, our population has changed. We've acquired the Louisiana Purchase. Industry is booming. Remember, with greater food production comes bigger population. So the population becomes 10 million people, and 2 million of those, or 20%, live west of the Appalachian Mountains. There are no roads, boys and girls, to get out there. In fact, at the time, taking the trails, it would take a trip from New York to Buffalo, New York, which is 363 miles, 3 weeks to complete. Most of that was done by Conestoga wagon, shown right here. But times would change. With innovation and technology, we would soon be using the steamboat. Sooner after that, the locomotive and steamboats. On to this. Roads and turnpikes is the next idea. A turnpike. Think about this. Massachusetts has a turnpike. Ohio has a turnpike. There's lots of turnpikes in the United States. What are these, you might ask? They're toll roads. Who likes tolls? Not this guy. You probably don't like them either. They slow you down unless you have an eye pass, but that's another story. To fill the need for travel out west, private companies learn to make a profit. Remember capitalism? Remember free enterprise? People are out to make a dollar, and the government allows it. Anyways, companies started to build turnpikes, also known as toll roads. And what did they do? They charged a fee to use them, yes, to make their money. The first one was a corduroy road made of crushed stone, sometimes logs like shown in this picture. Could you imagine taking a Conestoga wagon on a corduroy road? Would be insane. Ohio would soon join the United States in 1803. We've heard of this before. Remember the Treaty of Greenville? We conquered those natives because they were attacking American settlers. It would be the next Great Valley and the place that would become a United State. The National Road would soon be made. Why, might you ask? The federal government would purchase and buy and pay for the National Road. It was completed in 1818, and it was seen as a military necessity. This should be a no-brainer, boys and girls. Why, might you ask, did we build the National Road? To get our troops out there quickly to protect American settlers. This is similar to the Alcan Highway. This is short for the Alaskan Canadian Highway, built in the 1950s to protect the United States and the purchase of Alaska from the Russians, which we were fighting in the Cold War. The Cold War, boys and girls, was a fight between democracy, United States, and communism in Russia. And this highway, which basically links the lower 48, the 48 states like Wisconsin, Montana, Washington, it's linked to Alaska through a road. It's made of gravel. River travel would soon become popular. Not only was river travel faster and more comfortable, it was also gave us an ability to carry far more goods, right? Very hard to weigh down a boat with goods. It can be done, but it takes a lot of stuff. The disadvantages to river travel were two. Number one, pretty much limited to north and south travel. If we think of the Fox River, it flows north towards the Bay of Stinkards or Green Bay. The Hudson River in New York flowed south from Albany, New York, all the way to New York City and out to the Atlantic Ocean. And think of it this way. Downstream, really quick and easy, right? If we don't have a steamboat, but going upstream, very, very difficult. Could be done, but very difficult. This man right here is Robert Fulton. Remember, in our DBQ, we're trying to think of people who invented things and changed the world and how those inventions made life better for America. So Robert Fulton invented the power steamboat. He took the idea from a guy in Europe. So Fulton didn't create it the first time, but he put a wheel on the side of the boat. And this wheel, like a wheel in our first mills along a river, was propelled by a steam engine, and it moved the boat. Okay, it wasn't until later on that they ended up putting the wheel in the back to increase its efficiency. That, again, is another story. Fulton invented this in 1807. He called it the Clermont. And here is how incredible this machine, this boat, changed travel. Travel from New York to Albany took only 32 hours. Now that seems ridiculous today, right? You could drive across most of the country today in a car in 32 hours, but they had a boat, and that was fast. By a sailboat, using these things here and here, it took 4 days. So now we're reducing it by about 70%. What did the steamboat do? It had several impacts. Not only did it increase travel time, it made time, it didn't increase time, it reduced it, I should say. You were able to ship goods more easily and cheaper. Oranges from wherever, Florida, or peaches from Georgia, rather, and cotton from Georgia and southern states could now be shipped to the north much, much faster. It helped create cities like Cincinnati and St. Louis. Cincinnati's on the Ohio River. St. Louis is on the Mississippi. Here's a picture of the Erie Canal. Buffalo, New York is right here, and here's Albany. What an incredible thing the Erie Canal would be to help get the cotton and the tobacco from the south to and from places even faster. Travel east and west is our next topic. The geography of the United States was a natural problem. It limited boat travel really to north and south. So this created a need for a canal, the Erie Canal, right here, connecting Lake Erie to the Hudson River in New York, and it had to be artificially dug. Could you imagine doing it without technology? How many shovel scoops that would have been? It must have been insane. Anyways, the goal of the Erie Canal was to connect Albany here to Buffalo, New York, here on Lake Erie. And imagine if you can get from the river here along the Erie Canal to Lake Erie. You could get to Lake Ontario through Canada on the St. Lawrence River. You could get to Lake Huron, Lake Michigan, and Lake Superior over here by Wisconsin. Great thing. Glad they did it. It's 363 miles long, and we needed to build locks or compartments to raise the and lower the water levels. You see, the geography isn't perfectly flat. So when there is a low area here and you need to get your boat up here, they had to build these compartments, pump them full of water, drive your boat in, pump it up, your boat raises like this, and you can scoot out and move on. That is what a lock is. The Erie Canal opened in 1825 and was a great thing for the country. No steamboats, no problem. The Erie Canal was only in some spots about 6 feet wide. That's right, about the tall as Mr. Resch. So what did that mean? You had to drag barges up the river, up the canal. So how did you drag them? With mules. Mules would pull these boats along a canal. 24 miles was possible in one day. The steamboat, like canals, impacted America positively. It lowered the cost of shipping goods. It brought prosperity to towns that were on the canal routes, okay? And it united a growing country. It allowed people to move farther and farther and live farther and further away from rivers. So this was a great thing. This would really expand the amount of agriculture that would take place across our country from New York down to Georgia and Alabama. Our country would open up, and it would be even easier for people to get out west and make their own families, their own homesteads, their own farms, and eventually grow the United States to what it is today. Thank you, canals. Western settlement, as you can imagine, moving out west, would boom because of the use of the steamboat and canals and these national roads. People tended to follow the rivers out west. Why? Easy, comfortable travel, it was fast, and they could take a lot of stuff with them. Plus, we had canals now to get people out there. Two major places, rivers, would help people get out west very, very quickly. It was the Ohio River. So if New York is right there, the Ohio River actually, here's Ohio, goes below Ohio and through Kentucky and Tennessee that way. Okay? Great thing. It helped people get out east and west very quickly, and so did the Mississippi, which they could have taken from New Orleans upriver towards Illinois and Chicago and Wisconsin. New states would be formed, obviously, as more people would take steamboats and use canals to get out west. And with canals, remember, we're able to live farther apart, so those farmers could live really close to a canal, get their goods like corn and wheat and all that good stuff on the canal and get it to market quick. So new states form. By 1803, we have four new states, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, and Vermont. That's VT. And then by 1820, we have five more, Illinois, Indiana, Missouri, Mississippi, and Alabama. Okay, boys and girls, in short, there's a lot of things that helped America move out west, and you should consider these as positives during the Industrial Revolution. What were they in short again? Remember that we had lots of growing population happening, and we had to move people out west, and with needs, create inventions. And inventions, or things like the Turnpike and Corduroy Road and National Road, would help people move out west faster. Remember, as river travel became more popular, good prices got lower, and people could travel more comfortably, we reduced the cost of goods as well. Inventions like the steamboat by Robert Fulton in 1807 and his Clermont helped make travel faster, even safer and cheaper. All right, we would use canals because we were limited in our north and south travel by many of the rivers at the U.S. at the time, so we could hand dig these waterways, even though they were pretty narrow, and we could help get goods east and west. Finally, remember there's lots of impacts. Not only did it unite our growing country between east over here and west over here, but it would help lower the cost of shipping goods, bring prosperity to towns that were not exactly on a river, and it helped people live farther and further away from those big cities in the coast. That's all I've got for you, boys and girls. Hope you took something away you can use for your DBQ. See you later.